So when muscles are activated, they are able to contract and contract on demand. It's a reflexive component of muscle activation. And those are the slow twitch muscle fibers that actually have the lowest threshold to activation. So in the ideal state, these motions and these movements occur beyond our conscious control. So we talk about stress, trauma, and overuse, and the resultant inflammation is what alters the communication between the nervous system and the muscle system, which in turn creates weakness. And so when I'm looking at this weakness, it's actually the slow twitch muscle fibers that are negatively affected by inflammation. And these slow twitch muscle fibers actually begin to pick up fast twitch characteristics. So there's metabolic changes that actually occur in the muscles themselves where they fatigue at a higher rate. But the main factor is that they lose their oxidative capacity, which is a component of the increased fatigue rate, but they also have a higher threshold to activation. So when slow twitch fibers pick up fast twitch characteristics, the threshold to activation gets higher, so they need more electrical impulses or energy to actually create a muscle contraction. And the muscles will lose their ability to be able to contract and contract on demand, which means now they can't do their job to stabilize joints and resist the forces that come relative to unexpected loads. So when we see weaknesses from an MAT standpoint, it's more of a neurological issue where the muscle can't contract on demand and sustain that contraction. That's completely different than saying, I'm going to push as hard as I can on your leg and I want you to try and resist me. That's a strength test. When we're looking at the test that we do, we're trying to identify neurological weaknesses.